Again and again, my conversations come back to the solid walls that religion puts up, back to implacable faiths. My holy book is true. I am right. He is wrong. So I went to meet someone who, in my naivety, I thought might be able to see both sides of the story. Yusuf Al-Khattab used to be called Joseph Cohen, born and brought up as a secular Jew in New York. In 1998, he moved to Gaza as a Jewish settler. But there he discovered a different God, Allah.
What I noticed coming to this center of world religions, what a lot of hatred religion fosters. I mean, I'm an atheist and I'm rather gentle. I don't hate people, but it seems to me that I'm hearing hate on all sides, and it seems to me all to do with religion.
I hate atheists because atheists don't care if somebody fornicates in the middle of the street. They don't care if they're women go bouncing around on TV topless. It makes no difference to them. They don't believe anything. If you don't believe in a set rule and you believe that a constitution can change and you can amend the rules as they go along and you don't believe in God's rule, then what law do you have? You just have man-made laws.
I realized I was in the company of someone who has willingly bought into fundamentalist dogma.
What do you think about the September the 11th attacks on New York and the July the 7th attacks on London?
Okay, since you like to speak about evolution, I like to start before. What do you think about the Jews that have destroyed over 417 Arab villages, including all mosques and masjids, which wouldn't affect you because you're an atheist? So what are you saying, that we should sit back and say, oh, you know what, let us progress and let us sit down and drink tea and talk about what to do? I think that's the most ridiculous thing. All I could say is, if there was no quote-unquote state of Israel, there would have been no September 11th.
But if we've all got to live together, it's not going to be helped if there are people of very, very strong faith who simply know they're right and are not amenable to argument, because there's somebody out there who's just as faithful as you and has his faith just as strong as yours, which is opposite to yours.
You see, the problem is, Richard, I think that you have fear. You know that this party of occupying Muslim lands and polluting society with these evil ideas that are around, it's not going to last forever. There will always be the soldiers of Allah there to give the response to this. So we also want the same thing. All we want is that we want the non-Muslims at this point off the lands of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All the lands of Muhammad, we want the kuffar out of it.
Do you want Islam to take over the rest of the world?
Of course I want it to, and it will. So my advice is to clean up your show at home, take your forces off our lands, correct yourselves, fix your society, all right? Fix your women.
Fix your women. That's not my business. That's my women's business.
No, it's
not.
No, it is your business. It is your business. When you take the women and dress them like whores on the street.
I don't dress women. They dress themselves.
I do it now. But you allow it as a norm to let the women go on the street dressed like this. What's going on with your society?
But I'm interested in religion and the effect that it has on people's minds, and I'm worried about it.
And we're very worried about you. What's going on with the stealing, with the theft? It's out of control.
Clearly, historic injustice towards the Palestinians breeds hatred and anger. But we must face up to the fact that in creating the death cults of suicide bombers, it's unshakable, unreasonable conviction in your own righteous faith that is the key. If preachers then tell the faithful that paradise after martyrdom is better than existence here in the real world, it's hardly surprising that some crazed followers will actually swallow it, leading to a terrible cycle of vendetta, war, and suffering.